Hello?
Who am I speaking with?
Hi, my name's Devon. How can I help you?
I'm sorry, your name is Devin?
That's correct. How can I help you?
Devin. Okay, Devin. And you work for who? I'm sorry, who am I calling?
You don't know who you called?
Yeah, I know who I called, but I don't believe that that you're a serious news organization. So I'm just
Give me
curious,
indi-
and I'll tell you why. Because you called me on Tuesday when I was at work, and
This
you
is
called me a
this is
liar, and you took up
okay.
valuable time of mine, and you told me I was stupid, and then you called me back today, and you tried it all over again, and then you announced to me that it was a prank, and then you offered to send me something via fax so that I could authorize you using my voice,
Yeah.
and then you denied it. And then the guy I just talked to, who transferred me to you, said that it's a serious news organization.
Yes.
And which I find odd, because how can you be a serious news organization but you're actually prank calling people? And
Well,
so,
obviously you don't know how this
and then with all due
works.
respect to Gaius, who I just got off the phone with, he was a little put off that I was bothering him at work, right? And I said, well, that's odd, because you called me at on Tuesday when I was at work, and you called me again today when I was at work. Doesn't seem to
Yeah, you
bother
do
anyone
seem to
on your
talk a
end
lot.
when you get phone calls at work. And you don't have any problems doing it to me. And you don't have any
Well, it's
problems
part of
lying
our
to me.
job.
And you don't have
It's
any
part of our
problems.
job.
You don't have any problems insulting me. And you don't have any problems taking up my valuable time. And I just
Well,
figured
you're
I'd
kind
return
of
the favor. Don't you
asking
think that's
for
fair?
it. You're kind of
No, Devin,
whiny,
it's an
and
easy
you're
question
kind
to
of
answer.
asking
Do you
for
think
it.
that's fair?
Very fair. Sure.
It is fair.
It's a
Okay, so you
business
don't
we're
have
in,
any
right?
problems with me
Customer
calling
service.
you and talking to you right now and harassing you a little bit and maybe making your work life a little challenging, more so than it needs to be. You don't have any problems with that at all then, right?
Oh, not at all.
Not at all. Why would you, right? Because that's what you do. That's what you do for a living, right?
Exactly. It is part of my
Yeah,
job.
you call up people and you
I
tell them
deal
they're
with assholes
liars
like
and you
you
make
all day
stuff up
long.
and you call them at difficult times and make them really, make their lives miserable.
Oh.
And that's cool, right? As long as it's
That's
funny.
not what we're doing. It's all for
Well, no.
fun.
I disagree, Devin. Because let me tell you why I disagree. Because when you called me
Okay.
on Tuesday, I was in the middle of managing an extremely important high-profile event. You know who was there? You know who was in
Jared
attendance? Lots of important people, Jay Leno being one of them. And you took me away
Leno.
from an extremely important event that I put a lot of
Couldn't get
time
his
and effort
autograph.
into.
I'm
It was
sorry.
extremely important to me. It was extremely important to
Yeah.
my company. It was an extremely important event to the Oregon Health Sciences University. It was an extremely important event to the Early Detection Cancer Association. It was an extremely
Oh,
important event to the hundreds of scientists from around the world that came to Portland, Oregon on Tuesday at the hotel that you called, and you interrupted me in the middle of this important event. So I get that you don't care and that it doesn't bother you in the least to have people call you at work and give you a hard time while you're trying to do your job, because that's what you
I
do for a
asked you.
living. That's not what I do for a living, but it's what you do for a living. So you're real good at it.
You
And
don't
it should
deal
be
with
fun for you,
customers?
right? Are you having
You don't
fun?
deal with... Yeah.
Oh,
I
you are.
am.
Okay,
Thank
great. Then
you.
let's keep talking then. What do you say? How about that, Devin? What do you think? Why don't you go
Let's
ahead and
do
fax
it.
that authorization over to my fax number again, and then we'll talk
Okay.
about getting this on the radio,
That
on your
sounds
show.
wonderful. Thank
How about
you.
this? How about you and I develop a few more lies that maybe you can use the next time you call someone and bother them at work
Oh, that would be
about how
great.
serious
Do
of
you
a
have
news
any good
organization you
ideas?
are, and about how I'm
Do you have
supposed
any
to
good
know
ideas?
who Richard Washington is, and about
Am
how
I
I'm
supposed
supposed to be aware of some made-up bullshit
You
story
don't
that
know
you
who Mr.
decided to fabricate
Washington is?
and call me a liar on? How about that?
Probably because
How
you're,
do you like being called a liar, Devin? Just out of curiosity, you like it? Do you like it? Be honest with me.
Well,
I mean, all
nobody
joking
calls me
aside,
a liar.
person to person, human being to human being. And at the end of
Oh,
the day,
just
let me
to
just
keep
mention
my
one
head.
other thing,
Please get
Devin,
a
and I'll let you go,
degree.
okay? Because I don't want to
Please
bother
get a
you at work
degree.
like you bothered me at
You
work. I'll just say
want
this,
to think?
okay?
You want
When you call people up and you bother them at work and you call them liars
Sir, when did
and
I
you make
call
stuff
you?
up for your own benefit because you think it's funny, you know what? It may be funny to you. It may be funny to a lot of people, but it's not funny to me. And if you have any fucking heart at all, any
Oh,
heart,
watch the
even a
language.
little bit
Watch
of a
the
heart,
language.
even a little small bit of a heart, you'll think
Yeah.
twice before you do it again. But you know what? I don't expect that to happen. Because this is what you do for a living. And with all due respect to you and the people you work with, it's not a very great way to make a living if you want to know the truth.
It's actually
so maybe
really
you live in a cloudy place.
It.
Maybe your life is full of dark clouds. How about that? Where do you live?
Because
you seem to know so much about me. Let's talk about you, Devon. Where are
no,
you at? What do you do for a living? Where do you live? What do you have for
I'm
dinner last night?
At this lovely... Oh, what did I have for dinner last night? What did I have for dinner last night?
Can you remember that far back? Tell me, would you have a hot dog? Would you have... Would you have a burrito? What'd you have?
A hot dog.
What'd you have? A hamburger? Would you have some vegan tofu meatballs? What'd you have? Tell me what you had for dinner last night. It's not a tough question. You ought to be able to remember. It was only 24 hours ago. Huh?
Yeah.
You have some soup? You have some hot soup?
I had a sandwich.
A piece of corn on the cob? What'd you have?
Oh, I had a sandwich.
You had a sandwich. Oh, you had a sandwich. Okay.
Uh-huh.
No, you didn't have a sandwich last night, Devon. I know you didn't have a sandwich last night.
How do you know?
You know how I know? Because you're a liar. That's how I know. You're a liar. No, you're
Sir,
a liar.
You don't even know me.
You don't even know who I am. You don't know how important I am. You don't. You know my name is Chris. And,
is Brian
you know,
Washington.
I'm insulted, actually, that you don't know who I am. You should really know who I am. And you're lying about having a sandwich last night for dinner, too, by the way. I know you're lying. Don't even try to convince me that you're not. Don't do it. Don't even make any noise. You're not telling the truth. You're not truthful. You're a liar.
You need to look into Brian Washington. I'm surprised you don't know who he is, and I can understand you being a little jealous.
Really? Have you Googled Brian Washington's name? Why don't you do that right now? You got a computer in front of you? Brian Washington, who reported on Nightline? Brian Washington, who worked for ABC News? Brian Washington is a serious journalist?
Yes,
well, you go ahead and do that. I've looked into Brian Washington a little bit. Brian Washington is not
who he says he is. Are you sure you're spelling it correctly?
I'm sorry?
It's B-R-I-A-N. Or it's B-R-I-A-N.
B-R-I-A-N. Wait. Let me get this right. I want to make sure I get this right because I'm really good with writing. Because, gave his name, you write his name down so I wouldn't get it wrong. So I got a pencil in my head. Let me see. Wait. B-R.
As in boy.
I-A-N? I-A-N, B-R-I-A-N.
That's
common
stone.
You know what's funny about that? That's how I spelled his name when I looked on Google. And it's also how my private investigator spelled his name when he did a little homework as well. And it's also how my public relations manager spelled his name when she too looked. And guess what? Brian Washington is not a famous journalist. He probably wasn't even born when Nightline was on during the fall of the Berlin Wall. Does he even know what year the fall of the Berlin Wall happened? Does he even know what Berlin is?
He's very intelligent. Do you want me to get him back on the line?
Oh, he's so intelligent. Let's talk about that for a minute. He's so intelligent that he calls someone up on a Tuesday night claiming to be something that he's not and calling me a liar and interrupting me at work. But that's the sign of an intelligent person.
Sir.
I'm sorry.
What's your
go ahead.
So
you were saying. I'm sorry,
you.
Devon. You
What's
were saying.
Your fact
I apologize. You were saying something.
Oh, you really like. To hear
is this bothering you?
It's your fact number. No.
I'm sorry. Is this bothering you? Am I bothering you? While you're at work, I'm just curious. I mean, it's okay if I am. I'll hang up.
Give
you the courtesy
like
of that
you
because you didn't give me the courtesy of that on Tuesday night or today.
Look.
Earlier at work when I was there, you didn't give me the courtesy
of
that.
You
kept talking over me. You kept talking over me. You kept interrupting. You kept calling me a liar. You kept doing all that right up to the point where you told me it was for a prank radio show. So I'm just curious. Am I interrupting you? Because I don't want to do that. I want to be better than that. I want to try to do a little better than you guys were.
Oh, let's drive. Push for it.
Yeah, let's try it. What do you say? How about that? How about you answer me a question? Serious news or prank?
Uh-huh.
Serious news or prank?
Serious news.
Which one is it? Multiple choice. A, serious news. B, prank. C, none of the above. What is it?
Serious news, sir.
Serious news, right? Okay. Serious news. So when you're reporting on serious news, does it usually require a fax being
I'm
sent
kidding.
To the person
sure.
so that they can
it's
release that on air? Is that how serious news really works?
No, because
no,
I'm a liar.
It's not how it really works, right? It's not how
it's
it really works.
It's a prank for a warning show.
I'm sorry?
Can we back over that? It really is a prank for our morning show.
Oh,
so
it's
can
a
we
prank
back
for the
over?
morning show. So we're getting somewhere now. So it's not hard
Yeah.
news. Oh, okay.
Wow.
Well, let's see. Not only
We
has
throw
Mr.
some hard news
Washington
in
lied
there
to me
every
about
once
this
in a
being hard
while.
news, not only has
Oh,
Gaius lied about this being
Mr.
hard news, but
Washington lied to you?
now Devon is saying it's not hard news, and it's for a morning show. What's the name of the morning show, just out of curiosity? What's the name of this morning show?
Dippy and Dippy morning show?
What's the name of the morning show?
Skippy and Dippy?
Skippy and Dippy. Skippy and Dippy. What's funny about that is no matter how hard I look online for the Skippy and Dippy morning show, I'm not finding it anywhere. I'm
Are you
finding
spelling
some
it
information
correctly?
about a guy a few years ago who was so thoroughly disgusted with the way that you guys do business that he decided to turn the tables on you a little bit. That was pretty entertaining. But I couldn't find anything online about Skippy and Dippy morning show. I couldn't find out about where to listen to it or how to listen to it because I think it's entertaining. I'd love to listen to it. How do I listen to it? What radio station is it on?
Well, it's not in your city. That's what we don't call.
Oh, it's not in my city. Well, the good news is that I can probably stream it online, right? I ought to be able to find it online, right? What it's syndicated. Is it syndicated? Is it syndicated? Is it on the interweb? How do I find the Skippy and Dippy morning show?
You should be
Because
able
I want
to
to be able
stream
to
it
hear
online.
my I want to be able to hear my bit. I want to be able to hear
Oh,
it.
your bit. Yeah.
Yeah, I want to be able to
Ever
hear my
since
bit.
you listen to yourself, of course you do. You
Yeah,
love
so
to
I'll
hear
tell you what, let's
yourself
make a deal.
talk.
How about this? Let's make a deal. Let's negotiate, Devin. How about if you give me, a couple of stations that I can pick this up on, and I'll give you my fax number.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, let's do that. What do you think? Give me one station that this is syndicated on. One.
If you just Google it,
No, no, I have. I've got
from
my computer right here in front of me. I've
iHeartRadio
Googled Skippy and Dippy Morning Show. Why don't you Google Skippy and Dippy Morning Show? What do you see? Because I'm not seeing
I do.
anything.
It's set as my homepage. It's on
The Skippy. Okay, so
iHeartRadio.
so it's on the internet. So why don't you give me the URL? Let me see what I can find. Let me see what this is all about.
iHeartRadio
Because I've got a
backslash.
sense of humor. I got a sense of humor. I listen to. I listen to. I got a sense of humor. I listen to Howard Stern in the morning. I like prank radio. So here I am. Let me see. I'm in front of my computer. What's the URL again? What is it?
iHeartRadio. iHeartRadio / Skippy and Dippy.
iHeartRadio / Skippy. And
you
Dippy?
Can also find the 104.1 New Rock.
No, no, wait, stop. Slow down now. Slow down. I'm not as smart as you are. You've already told me that. You already know that. You and Gaius and Mr. Washington have already, all of you, said that I'm not very smart. So you're going to have to slow down for a minute because I'm not very smart. So start over. iHeartRadio. You tell me when I'm wrong if I make a mistake, okay? Because I know you care about me. iHeartRadio. How am I doing? So far, so good? / Skippy, SKIPPY. Is that right? iHeartRadio, Skippy. Is it AND? Or is it one of those little weird little symbols? AND?
It's just N.
Oh, just the letter N. Okay. Skippy,
Isn't that
N,
clever? I can't
Dippy.
Help that.
Dippy, common spelling on Dippy? DIPPY, common spelling, you think? iHeartRadio / Skippy and Dippy. Is that it, or is there like something else?
It's DIPY.
DIPY. So
no,
it's not common spelling. Oh, see,
no.
You're keeping me on my toes here. Now I agree. I am stupid because I would never have thought Dippy was with just one P. But let's give that a shot. So thanks for your help, by the way, Devin. This is great.
Anytime.
iHeartRadio / SKIPPYNDIPY. Is that right? Let me slow down for you in case you missed that. I'm just trying to figure out that I'm heading in the right direction. iHeartRadio / Skippy N Dippy spelled DIPY. Is that right?
Oh, we're no longer. Oh, shit. Apparently, we're no longer associated with iHeartRadio.
Oh, you're not associated with iHeartRadio.
So let me
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Wait a minute. You're not associated with iHeartRadio anymore?
No, clear that out. Clear that out.
So you didn't know that before now. This is awesome. You're learning something. We're just learning together. This is great, isn't it? Don't you feel
so
great about this?
Yeah, my mom told me to learn something new every day. Here.
Yeah, man, you're not stupid. I know I am because you call me stupid, but you're not stupid. We just learned something together at the same time. Oh, sure. You didn't call me stupid? Oh, well, see, no. Your friend Gaius did, and Mr. Washington surely did. In addition to calling me a liar,
his name wrong. It's Gaius.
In addition to calling me a liar, all right, do you think I'm a liar?
It's
a liar? I'm just curious.
Do you want to look at the website or not?
Yeah, yeah. Why don't we get back to that? We'll get back to me being a liar in a few minutes. But yeah. So what's the URL? Tell me what to look up.
Okay.
It's not iHeartRadio. So what is it?
G-L-O-R-Y.
Glory. Gotcha.
H-O-L-E.
Oh, glory hole. I get it.
F is in Frank.
Wait, back up. I'm sorry. I lost you at glory hole. So it's G-L-O-R-Y-H-O. I'm sorry. I'm with you up to O.
L-E.
So it is glory hole. Okay, glory hole, and then what?
F is in Frank.
Oh, F is in fucker. U is in fucker.
O.
D is in fucker. Is that what you're getting at? Glory hole fucker?
I'm a lady. I would appreciate it if you watched your language.
Oh, but that only works with ladies, right? Because if I say I'm not a liar, I would appreciate not being called a liar, then you guys would be cool with that. You wouldn't call me a liar, even though,
well,
you
that's
know, it's
between
all for
you
fun.
And Mr. Washington.
I'm just joking around here.
Okay.
I appreciate
so
you letting me know you're
called?
A lady. I appreciate
oh,
that. I'm also an honest person. I don't lie. But I was called a liar. Didn't feel so good.
Oh.
So, I'm sorry. Let's be honest with each other for a second, Devon, shall we? Okay? We've established the fact that you're a lady and I'm not a liar. Okay,
uh-huh.
So that's good. We're making progress. What's the URL? Why is it that when I type in your shit on Google, nothing productive pops up? Why is that? Why don't you try
type
it?
Your shit on Google?
No, when I type in Skippy and Dippy show, when I type in the radio show, when I try to find you on the interweb, you're not there. Why?
Well, because we do.
Oh,
well,
but
do
you were on iHeartRadio, but you're not there anymore. So how do I find you online?
I'm trying to tell you, so.
No, well, you're not. You gave me glory hole something, and I know that's not right. So
no,
you're not really trying.
Did you leave? Where'd you leave off?
Well, no. So look,
glory
I'm not. I know it's not glory hole.
Gloryholefoundation.com/Skippy. Okay.
Let me just make sure, because those are big words. I want to make sure I got it right. Glory hole.
No.
Glory hole. Glory hole. Foundation. I can understand you being so sensitive about you know being a woman. Working for a company that's got a URL called Glory Hole Foundation. So I can appreciate that being a sensitive topic to you. And then
glory.
It's / and then I'm sorry, Glory Hole Foundation / Skippy?
No, .com.
Okay, so that's dot. That's not comma dot. Not comma dot. Dot, D-O-T. Oh, no, I guess you don't spell that out right. You just use the dot thing. C-O-M, and then is the / and then I hit the /
Canadian. You're funny.
Gloryholefoundation.com / and then what now?
Skippy.
It's actually called a forward slash, but we'll bring that. We'll talk
whatever.
About that later.
Oh, good for you.
Oh,
maybe
good for
you.
Thanks.
You
that's
job.
Encouraging. I appreciate your vote of confidence. Glory Hole Foundation, changing lives in the community, and our website. This isn't going to get me in trouble, is it? It's not going to, like, you're not watching me through your camera, are you?
I wish, but no.
That's good stuff right there. Congratulations.
Mm-hmm.
You suspected me with a, yeah, that's hot stuff right there. So, that's good. You just screwed me. Uh-huh.
Yeah, it sucks. I feel like it's gonna change.
Okay, so do you wanna get serious, or do you just wanna continue to mess around? Because I go all night. You know what? In fact, you know what you should do is you should fax me that release, and then maybe offer me a job on your radio show. I think I'm pretty good for a liar.
Yeah, I like you.
Yeah, I like
number.
Me too. I like me too.
Yeah.
I'm pretty good for a liar, all right? I mean, for a stupid liar, not bad. I'm pretty good looking too.
It sounds like you are.
Sounds
yeah.
like I'm what? Sounds like I'm good looking?
So,
why don't you let me send
know.
You some pictures? What's your phone number? I'll send you some pictures of
you. Give me your fax number. I'll fax over.
You already have my phone number, so why don't you give me your phone number?
No.
Devon, D-E-V-O-N. Oh, so why? What are you afraid? I mean, what are you afraid of?
Well, you're
we're
a potential
here.
Employee. You're a potential
no,
future
no,
employee.
No, no,
that
no, no, no. I'm not a potential employee. You couldn't afford me. You couldn't afford me. And I wouldn't
sure.
I wouldn't work for you. I wouldn't work
yeah.
for you.
You
I wouldn't
work
for
me.
You. What's that?
I'd make you work for me.
Nah, you wouldn't want me working for you. I mean, y'all, I promise you wouldn't want me working for you.
Oh, don't say that.
Yeah,
don't get
no,
me out.
So, yeah, I know. I know. It's pretty
sad. You talk
a lot. I do talk a
uh-huh.
lot. But I figure, you know, but the one thing that I also do is I tell the truth. I do that. You know why? Because it's important.
Aww.
Yeah, I know. It's really kind of a lost art, you know, being truthful and honest with people. Don't you think?
It?
It's kind of a lost art. You guys aren't very
lunch.
Good at it, so I understand why it would be difficult for you to, you know what it feels like to have someone
yeah.
tell you the truth. But, you know, I mean, it is nice to be have someone be honest with you. Don't you think?
Yes.
But it's all fun and games. I get it. It's all fun and games. It's what you do. So let's make a deal. What do you think, Devon? Let's make a deal. Let's make a deal right now. What do you say? You leave me alone. You leave me alone, and you stop calling me. How about that? Yeah.
I will never call
you that. Why don't you fax me something that says I will no longer bother you at work and call you a liar? How about that? Hey, here's something. I got a deal for you. I'm gonna give you my fax number legitimately. I mean, I'm not lying to you yet. I didn't lie to you the other night, even though you told me I was lying to you. You
mm-hmm.
haven't, you know, I've been honest with you. I'll give you my fax number, right? And all I need for you to do is fax
mm-hmm.
me something first that says Chris Bebo is not a liar. How about that? You do that, and then I'll give you my fax number. What do you say? Sound like a good deal?
I have to fax you something, and then you're going to give me your fax number? I need that first.
Okay, no, why don't you do this? Why don't you raise your right hand and repeat after me?
Okay.
Yeah, raise your right hand, tap it on the
uh-huh.
table, tap it on the wall, tap it on your head. I want to hear it. I
want
to make sure you actually have a hand and not a hook. You really got a hand, because I don't trust people with hooks.
I don't
trust people with hooks. You know,
that's
those people freak me
hook.
Out. They scare me. And actually, people
no,
whose names start with a D kind of freak me out a little bit, too. But, you know, and if your name is Devon, you actually have a right hand for a right hook for a hand, then I can't continue to talk to you. Okay, so raise your right hand, Devon. Repeat after me. This is
that
not
a
serious
one.
News story. Raise your right hand and repeat after me. This is not a serious news story, and you're
this
not a liar.
This is a serious news story.
No, 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 no. You said, you're supposed to say, this is not a real news story, and you are not a liar.
This is not a real news story. It's
no,
not
no,
real
I thought
news.
What you said was, this is not a news story. I thought you said Dory.
Uh-huh.
I can understand why I'd be confused because the movie, you know, Finding Dory is out. What I need for you to do is articulate.
Yeah.
Keep your hand raised. Don't lower
that?
Your hand. This is not a real news story, and you are not
I
a liar.
That. Well,
okay,
I
go.
Can't. No, because you know, here's the deal. Here's the deal, buddy. I don't know if you're not a liar or not. I can't.
I'm sorry.
You know,
were you talking? I wasn't paying attention to you there for a second. Go ahead. Say that again.
I'm stupid.
Your feelings are hurt. You know what, Devon, if
aww.
I felt like you actually had feelings, then I'd be bothered by it. But I know
aww.
You don't. I know you don't. I know you don't have feelings, so I'm not bothered by it. So raise your right hand and say, this is not a – okay, let's forget about the liar part, because you know what? To be honest with you, I've lied more than once in my life. So I'm not gonna lie about that, you know. I lied
to
my first wife about chewing tobacco. You want to hear a funny story? My wife smelled tobacco on my lips, and I said, I don't know what you're talking about. I'm not chewing tobacco. And then I walked in the bathroom, and I found a bunch of tobacco in my teeth, and she divorced me because I chewed tobacco and lied about it. So I am a liar. So I won't make you say that. But how about this? How about if you raise your right hand and you say, hey, Chris, this is not a serious news story.
I already told you this was for a
prank call.
No,
because you retracted it. You retracted it because I made you say that I'm not a liar, and you didn't feel comfortable with that. So I'm trying to separate the two. So I just want the one. I just want you to say, Chris, this is not a serious news story.
Chris, this is not a serious news story.
No, but your hand's not raised. You need to raise your hand.
How do you know?
Because I know. Raise your hand and say, this is not a real news story.
This is not a real news story.
Oh, and I'm not a liar. And I love my job, and I think it's great calling people and bothering them at work. Would you be able to say that at all, or does the contract that you signed and your high moral standard prevent you from even recognizing that fact?
I love my job. I love.
I'm sure you do. I'm sure you do. But you don't have any problems bothering people at work, right?
I love calling people and giving people great customer service at work. That's my job.
Oh, that's your job.
I'm not calling and bothering you at work right now, am I?
No, but you work for someone who does, though. That's the thing. You know what's funny about millennials? I'm thinking you're probably a millennial because you sound pretty young. But, you know, the thing about millennials is that they generally, I know a little bit about this because I went to school for it, but don't hold that against me because I know you think I'm stupid. But really, I have a master's degree in multi-generational management, and so one of the things I learned is that millennials tend to align their jobs and their employment with their internal moral compass. So meaning that, you know, like let's say someone thinks that it's important for companies to be ethical and to treat people with respect and to, align the company's moral compass with their own. That's usually important for people, like, you know, in your age group. So, so I'm assuming that the company you work for does all that, right? Right?
I wasn't listening to anything you were saying. I'm sorry.
Oh, you weren't? Okay, that's too bad.
I was checking my text messages. What were you?
Oh, no, it's not important, Devin. It's not worth going backwards and talking about. Okay, here's my fax number. You ready? Here's my fax number.
I'm ready.
Okay, you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, here it is. Let me make sure I get this right, though. Okay, I got my business card, you know, because I don't know. It's hard for me to memorize 7-digit numbers, so, you know, I have to find a business card so that I can make sure that I give it outright, because I'm not that smart. You know how I know I'm not that smart? Because the guys that I talked to on Tuesday told me I wasn't, and your friend Gaius this morning, Gaius. I can't help it. He said his name was spelled G-A-I-U-S. So I just
That's
I pronounced that Gaius.
You.
But he made me write it down because he told me I wasn't smart enough to remember it.
That's awfully
millennial. So he made me write it down. I'm curious, where did Gaius go to school? Did he go to ITT Tech? Did you graduate from DeVry or the Motorcycle Mechanic Institute of America?
No, he went to Everest College.
Oh, Everest, yeah. So what's that like? I think I've seen that like late night TV. So it's like auto mechanic, that kind of, that's cool. That's a good school. Is that like an AA degree?
When your wife leaves you and you don't have anything else to do or go on.
Oh
sometimes.
No! I've long since remarried. I've been married for 16 years this Saturday. In fact, if you would want to send me a gift certificate to Red Robin or something like that, as a gesture of appreciation for the comic relief that I've provided for you, that would be nice too. You can email that or you can fax that to me. Here's here's a fax number. You got a pen? I want to make sure you got a pen. No, but you're smart. You graduated from Evanston.
Okay?
You can remember seven numbers. I can't because
I'm
not
that
smart. I can't remember that because when I went to Northwestern University in Chicago, Illinois, I didn't have to take reading, writing,
bragging.
Or arithmetic.
Quit bragging.
Oh, no, no.
You.
I'm sorry.
Bragging camps out.
You said bragging? I'm sorry. What'd you say? I'm having bragging. Okay. Yeah, you're right. That's bragging. Mm-hmm. I didn't mean to brag about where I went to school. You should be proud of where you went to school, though, Everett. That's a great school. So, okay, here you go. Here. Well, tell Gaius that I said congratulations on Everett. That's good stuff.
Maybe I'll give him your red rock.
Here's the fax number. You ready? You got a pen, or do you just want to memorize it? Okay, here it is. So fax is spelled F-A-X, just so you know. And so here's the number. Here's the number. You may have to dial a 1 first. I don't know how it works in your world, but you know, in mine you got to dial 1. So, but that's assumed. So we'll skip that. So here's the number: 503. Let's repeat that. 503-241-212. Okay, you got it? Will that work?
That's not enough numbers then.
I'm sorry, it's not enough numbers? It's seven numbers, right? There's seven numbers. There's the area code, and then there's three numbers, and then there's a dash, and then there's four numbers, right? So I gave you seven numbers, 1-503-241-212. So there's seven numbers, right? What's that?
I see what you did there.
What did I do? Am I being funny? I'm sorry?
You're so funny.
I'm funny. No, I ain't no dummy. I ain't no dummy.
Why don't you have your wife stroke your ego and give me your fax number?
No. My wife doesn't need to stroke my ego. That's not how my relationship with my wife works. I stroke my own ego, usually 2 or 3 times a night. Okay, so 5, I'm sorry, here we go. Let's do it again. 1-503. It's not going to work if you interrupt me. Devin, it won't work if you interrupt me. Okay, so don't interrupt me. It won't work if you interrupt me, okay? Don't interrupt me. Just hang on a second, Devin. Hang on, wait a second. I'm going to put you on speakerphone, and then you can talk to my wife. Because she just got home. She just went to that movie, Finding Dory. You want to ask her how it was? Sarah, did you just go see that movie, Finding Dory? How was it? Did you like it? My wife said, because I know you're a serious news organization, so maybe you have like an entertainment section to your news organization. Do you want my wife to give you a little movie synopsis of Finding Dory? Would that be funny?
Hang on. How does your wife put up with you?
She puts up with me. I know, that's a good question. I'm not really sure. I don't really know.
Yeah.
Did you get the fax number, though? I gave it to you 3 times. Did you write it down?
Yeah.
Did you write it down? Just out of curiosity.
Uh-huh.
Did you write it down?
Uh-huh.
Maybe repeat it again. I want to make sure you got it because it's really important that I get this fax.
503-2-something-something-something-something.
Oh, you didn't write it down. See, Devin, that's where things fell apart. Okay,
I tried to remember it.
I know.
Okay.
I mean, I know when you went to Everett College, they probably told you how to memorize 7 or 8 words, right? 7 or 8 numbers at once. I'm sorry. I apologize.
503.
I'm sorry. I don't want to interrupt you. I don't want to interrupt you. I know we're kind of talking over each other here. So go ahead again. I'm sorry. No, I'm not interrupting you. You're interrupting yourself. So go ahead. Say that number again. Say it again.
Oh, that's funny.
I know. It's cute, isn't it? It's endearing.
Hey.
It's endearing. Yeah. I'm endearing. I'm sorry. Say it again. 503. Let's say it together. Do you want to sing a song instead? Do you want to sing
nice
that song?
Nice when your
the world?
Significant other lies make you feel better. I love that.
Say again? What's that?
Uh-huh.
What's that? I didn't hear you. Say that again.
You
want me to send you a picture?
No, I want you to listen to me the first time. I don't like repeating myself.
Okay. I didn't mean to make you repeat yourself. That's unfortunate. I should apologize to you for that. I'm sorry. Hey, listen, we're getting close to 46 minutes here, which is about as long as you, which is about as much time as you wasted of mine on Tuesday and today. So, you know, I think out of fairness, I'll just go ahead and finish. I'll give you the fax number because I really, really want to get this fax from you. It's really important, that I get this fax, okay? So here it is.
You have kids.
503. Here it is. Write it down. I mean, you have a pen, right, or a pencil? They give you pens and pencils where you live, or do they not? I mean, are you in prison right now? I imagine if you're in prison, like working call center, they probably don't give you pens and pencils there. You might stab someone in the neck. I wouldn't want that. I don't want to be responsible for you getting another 4 to 5 years added on to your sentence for whatever it is. What are you in prison for, actually?
What did you do wrong?
Come on, Devon, be honest.
I've never been in trouble in my life. I'm a good girl.
How dare you? You're a good girl working for a serious news organization. Being honest with people. I forgot. Here you go. 503. Write it down. I'm going to give you all the numbers now. 503-241-2122. How about that? What do you say, Devon? Thank you. Devon, say thank you. Be genuine, though. Like, say it like you mean it.
Thank you.
Say it like you mean it, Devon. Bark like a dog. Say it.
Wow.
I know.
I'll make you bark.
Okay. Hey, Devon, my wife just got home from that movie, Finding Dory. I want to find out all about it, so I'm going to go now, okay? Is there, hey, Devon, is there anything else that you want to say before I hang up?